You likely remember hearing a letter from the first presidency read in your Warder branch several weeks ago. The letter announced that next Sunday, Easter Sunday, all wards and branches are to meet for sacrament meeting only, leaving additional time for worship at home as families to commemorate this most important holiday.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to
the fundamental principles of our religion are the testimony of the apostles and prophets concerning Jesus Christ, that he died, was buried, and rose again the third day, and ascended into heaven, and all other things which pertain to our religion are only appendages to it. Recently, Lisa and I attended the viewing of a dear friend, a woman of faith whose life was cut short by illness. We gathered with her family and close friends, exchanging fond memories of this beautiful soul. While standing away some distance from the casket, conversing with others, I noticed two young, primary age girls approach the casket and stretch up on their tiptoes, eyes just reaching its edge, to pay their final respects to their beloved aunt. With no one else nearby, Lisa slipped over and crouched down beside them to offer comfort and teaching. She asked how they were doing and if they knew where their aunt was now. They shared their sadness, but then with confidence brimming in their eyes, they said they knew their aunt was now happy and she could be with Jesus. At this tender age, they found peace in the great plan of happiness, and in their own childlike way testified of the profound reality and simple beauty of the resurrection of the Savior. I've observed that when President Russell M. Nelson gives a gift of the Book of Mormon to someone not of our faith, including world leaders, he often turns to 3 Nephi and reads about the appearance of the resurrected Christ to the Nephites. In doing so, the living prophet is in essence bearing witness of the living Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, the time has come foretold by prophets of old when the knowledge of a Savior shall spread throughout every nation, kindred, tongue, and people. We are seeing the fulfillment of this prophecy before our very eyes through the witness of Jesus Christ found in the Book of Mormon. No book does more to show that because of Jesus Christ, everything changed. Because of him, everything is better. Because of him, life is manageable, especially in the painful moments. I close with my testimony of the truthfulness of the Book of Mormon and of Jesus Christ as the Son of the living God. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.